Coming to you from deep inside the vaults of the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music, here is Tom Holmes, your curator and guide to vintage electronic music and audio experimentation.
This episode, Experimental Music for Pipe Organ. Music. This is Tom Holmes. Thanks for joining us today. You may ask yourself, why do I have a podcast devoted to pipe organ music on the Archive of Electronic Music? The pipe organ has always fascinated me because it represents the first widespread attempt to synthesize sound through the additive or subtractive combination of single sounds of different pitches and timbres. Much of what has been established in the world of traditional pipe organs translates meaningfully into the world of electronic music synthesis. The pipe organ produces sound by driving pressurized air through its organ pipes, triggered from a keyboard. Because each pipe produces a single pitch, the pipes are provided in sets called ranks, each of which has a common timbre and volume, as controlled by its associated keyboard or manual. A given rank, in turn, is controlled by a stop, a kind of on-off switch for one or more ranks. The use of stops enables the organist to selectively turn off certain ranks in order to produce different combinations of sounds, as opposed to hearing all sounds simultaneously. The player can effectively add or subtract sounds through a combination of organ stops. So a pipe organ has one or more keyboards, again, which are called manuals, played by both hands, and a pedal set played by the feet. And each keyboard controls its own division or group of stops. It has always been interesting to me that the dawn of electronic music on tape also saw a flowering of adventurous music for the pipe organ. The recordings featured here are primarily by artists who are also associated with new or contemporary classical music and electronic music. Christian Wolff, Morton Feldman, Giorgi Ligeti, Maurizio Kagel, and others. Then there is the case of Swedish composer Bengt Hambraeus, who was actually an organist himself. Inspired to make some of his earliest electronic music on tape with the pipe organ as the sound source. In this podcast, 11 of the 13 recordings date from 1956 to 1978, also the heyday for tape music and synthesized sounds. While most of these works are only for pipe organ, there are a few examples that are electronic music that incorporate sound material from the pipe organ or perhaps a synthesizer. Two of the works were created much more recently and are contemporary pieces for organ by Canadian Sarah Devachi and Danish composers Sandra Boss and Jonas Olsen. A name missing from this list is John Cage, whose Variations 1 and 3 have been interpreted and recorded for pipe organ by Gerd Zacher. I chose to bypass the Cage piece in favor of some lesser-known works by others. There are three albums in particular from which I have included several tracks in this podcast that I encourage you to look up. A Second Wind for Organ from 1968 on the Odyssey label, played by David Tudor, and then two albums from 1970 with the same title, Gerd Zacher Organ, or Gerd Zacher Orgel, released on the Heliodor and Deutsche Grammophon labels, each with a different set of organ selections played by German organist and composer Gerd Zacher. These are among the treasures that I picked up around the time of their release many years ago. One of the beauties of the pipe organ is that if you listen carefully, you can hear the mechanics of the instrument breathing, sometimes played ever so quietly as to highlight the keys being pressed, the stops being opened, or the bellows expanding and contracting. Other times, the organ can be extraordinarily loud, producing a wall of sound that is about as dense as it can get. I've included examples of various styles that incorporate these traits so that you can hear the variety of sounds that are possible with the pipe organ. Without further delay, let's begin our exploration of the pipe organ on this episode of the Archive of Electronic Music, Experimental Music for Pipe Organ. This is Tom Holmes.
Thank you. Thank you.
You are listening to Experimental Music for Pipe Organ on the Archive of Electronic Music. This is Tom Holmes.
Thank you. Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed Experimental Music for Pipe Organ, an historic look at the pipe organ as a sound synthesizer on the Archive of Electronic Music. This is Tom Holmes. Details about all of the music can be found in the playlist on the podcast website. Please check out my blog for the Bob Moog Foundation. There is a link on my podcast website. A transcript of notes for the program are found on my blog, Noise and Notations, located at tomholmes.com. If you would like to learn more about the history of electronic music, please read my book, Electronic and Experimental Music, published by Routledge, in print or as an ebook. You may also want to pick up a copy of my book about sound art, also available from Routledge. If you enjoyed this podcast, I invite you to explore our library of past episodes. They span many genres, technologies, and artists associated with electronic music, from symphonic rock to music for meditation, all inspired by vintage recordings from my archives. And with that, I say so long for now from the Archive of Electronic Music. Peace and happy listening.
All of the music heard on this podcast is brought to you from the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music, a curated collection of vintage recordings. For a complete playlist, go to the holmesarchive.podbean.com. All crackles, surface noise, and other imperfections heard in this podcast are purely intentional. All intro, outro, and other incidental music is by Tom Holmes, unless otherwise noted in the playlist. For notes about this episode, please see the blog Noise and Notations at tomholmes.com. So long from the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music.